Good morning, or good afternoon, or good evening, or good night. I don't know where you are right now or what time it is, but hello. So I'm just going over footage and stuff from yesterday. The highlight of yesterday was I mowed my lawn. Can you tell that I need to get back on the road? So hello to all my new subscribers who joined us recently. Hello. Usually I'd be traveling around the world making videos for you every day. At least this side of the world, North America. I travel all over North America, Canada, and the United States. Wherever I'm told to go, I go and I film it. That's usually what I do. It's actually not so much about my job, it's about my life, which is sort of wandering around, traveling. I'm just a guy living out here in the bush of Manitoba. I'm a bushman. But I'm a modern bushman. So, oh, 1 second. Do any of you like pop in the morning? Or for you Americans, soda? Pop. It's pop up here. We call it pop. So yeah, I'm up here in Canada. And the past week or so have been me waiting to get my truck fixed. Because I hit a moose. One of them big old Canadian moose. Yeah, we hit him and he took out my fender. It was a very minor collision, but it still cost $8,000 to repair it. So that's why I've been sitting at home, bored out of my tree. Not really bored, I've had a lot to do, but my videos have been me being at home for the past little while, so that's why. So guys, if you like the trucking content, which most of you do, I like that a little better myself too, but nothing I can do about it right now, but when I get back on the road, you betcha I'll put a title in the thing. Just hang in there, hang around there, hang in there. I'll put like a title, back to trucking or something in the vlog when we go back trucking, and you'll figure it out. It should be sometime next week. And then the vlogs will once again be traveling, but for the rest of you, for the majority of you who don't really care what I'm doing, thank you. I'm trying. It's been a stressful little time here. So I'm just going through the comments on today's video. Point A to B, what is this, MLD 146. I can zoom in a bit there. Yeah, I'm seeing a bunch of your comments on here. Where was I now? Oh great, now I lost my spot. You guys are funny. I'm sitting here giggling at all these comments. You guys are being really nice in the comments. Thank you very much. You guys are all very supportive. Make them feel good. I hit a moose. It's hard to feel down when you get so many people that just say so many nice things to you. I really appreciate all that, guys. You guys make my days better. Yeah, a lot of people, when I say that there's no Tim Hortons in the States, a lot of people are saying, like, here, Cynthia. Where are you? There you are. We have Tim Hortons everywhere in Michigan. Guy says, I'm also from Michigan, thought the same thing. Yeah, Michigan does have Tim Hortons everywhere. Ohio, some upstate New York. Pretty much everywhere around, oh, you're all zoomed in again. Jeez, guys, I know you like to be close to me, but back up a bit. There you go. Around Toronto and Ontario and the east, northeast states, New England, that area there, they have some Tim Hortons, but it hasn't really caught on because Dunkin' Donuts sort of owns that market. And that's cool, whatever. Your time will come when Tim Hortons will take over the world. So, maybe them and their dark roast. They're obsessed with their dark roast right now. Every time I go to Tim Hortons, would you like to try our dark roast? Huh? Huh? No. I just want a coffee. Why can't I just order my coffee? I like it when you go through the drive-thru and they have to, like, introduce themselves and give this, like, whole paragraph of a line. I don't know if you guys ever get that. Hi, my name is this and this, and would you like to try our dark roast coffee? Would you like a this and this? Would you like that and that? I really gotta film it once, because I can't remember off the top of my head what they say, but it takes forever for me just to say no.
You said it before. Never get a moose angry. Those things are crazy. Seriously, that's why I didn't go back and check on the moose that I hit. If you tick off a moose, which is pretty easy, they're territorial and they don't like people or things, what they'll do is these things are the size of a truck. They can weigh up to, what, 3,000 pounds? Somewhere around there, 2,000 to 3,000 pounds. They're big beasts. They're bigger than dairy cows. They are huge. What they'll do is they'll charge you. If you're in your semi-truck, they will destroy your semi-truck just for, you know, honking your horn at them or, you know, flashing your lights. Get off the road, moose! You go like that to them, that ticks him off because that's his road. You can't use his road. That's his road. And if you dare make a claim to his road, he will attack you. He will ram your truck. I've heard of big bull moose like charging semi-trucks and totaling the truck, ripping out the windshield, ripping off the doors. And then what do? All you got to do is just hide inside and hope that he stops. And then if you're outside the truck, what he'll do is he'll knock you over and he'll stomp on you with his front hooves. That's what they do. They don't kick like a horse does. No, they'll knock you over and they'll rear up and boom, 3,000 pounds of moose will come crushing down on your chest and your head, whatever they can hit. And then they just go to town on you. That's what moose do. So you're wondering, why didn't he go back and check on the moose? You want to go back and check on the moose? Fine. Go back and I'm getting out of here. I don't think she was dead because I only nicked her hind end. So pretty much she probably got knocked over, got really upset, got back up, tried to find out who hit her. And she was probably on the way because I pulled over about a half mile down, right, to check the damage on my truck. And I checked that damage as fast as I could. I got under my truck, ran around. And I'm like, no, my truck. Made sure nothing was falling off. I made sure the truck was safe to continue on, but oh, I was just like panicking. I was like, this moose is going to kill me. This moose is going to kill me. This moose is going to kill me. Oh, in reality, she probably went running off into the bush, but if she would have known that it was me, oh, she would have charged me. Especially if she had a young calf nearby. And if it was a bull moose, if there's a mama moose nearby, you know, he might think that you're trying to make a claim on his woman. Never make a bull moose angry. So yeah, lesson of the day is don't mess with moose. If you mess with Canada, we're bringing our moose with us and we're going to take you out. The things that come out of my mouth sometimes, like, did I just say that? Yeah, I did. I just got this picture because, you know, I learned about this whole NATO alliance thing. I learned about it in school. Like, don't get me wrong, they teach us these things. But it never really sunk in until I researched it on Google. What is NATO? It is the North Atlantic Treaty Organization. It's the world's most powerful alliance that has ever been. It's all the most powerful European and American nations, North American nations, that's Canada and the US, banded together into a solid alliance. So yeah, if, let's say, England, United Kingdom, they're part of NATO. If they were to get attacked, let's say by, who would attack them? Let's say if they were to get terrorist attacks by the terrorists. Because they're everywhere. I've been listening to CNN, there's terrorists everywhere. They could be in your backyard. I'm just joking. Don't be afraid. Don't let them scare you. But if they were to get attacked, by Article 5 of the NATO Treaty, all of the NATO members would be obligated to come to their defense. And this is where our moose come in. Because, you know, American come, they can come in guns blazing. Like, that would be a sight to see, just to watch the American military come down on these people. Just blah, 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 blah. Yeah, American power. I love the States. I love their military. But anyway, we don't got a military like that because we don't got the people, right? But we got moose. But don't tell anybody, they're our secret weapon. We'll come in with an army of moose, like the likes the world has never seen. So leave us alone, and leave our friends alone, or you will have to face our moose. Enough about that, guys. Let's go do something. Let's get out of here.
Yeah, we're gonna go into town, because we're bored. We could have gone into Winnipeg, but Winnipeg's far away from me now. I'm like an hour from Winnipeg, so we're gonna go into Steinbach. It's a little closer. Look at my little setup I got on my dash here, eh? Oh, it's funny. It works! Whatever! If anything happens anywhere around me, I will have it on film. Absolutely.
So mainly what this trip into town is for Timmy's. It's just not the same when I make it at home. We're gonna go get some Timmy's. I do need to go to Walmart too. All right, so much for a nice day. Hoping it'd be nicer than this anyway. So here we are in Steinbach. Debating which Timmy's to go to. I can go to that one over there or that one over there. I think I'm gonna go to that one over there. I don't know why, because I went to that one last time. I'm like right in the middle between the two, right? Of course I'm gonna get every light red because Steinbach times their lights perfectly. You see how those other lights, I don't know if you can see that far, they're all green up ahead? As soon as this light turns green, they'll turn red. Green means go! See? See what I mean? That's Steinbach for you. Why would you want traffic to flow smoothly? Oh well, you can find something to complain about in any city. I'll take the lights. This town is nice. I like it here. Third largest city in Manitoba. Did you know that? And Steinbach's got these weird intersections where the roads don't line up, so the intersection's all crooked. Or scheif, as they might say here. It's Low German for crooked, or offset, or weird, or kind of like that. There's Timmy's. Oh look, this one's going to Timmy's too. Everyone's going to Timmy's. Let's all go to Timmy's. Don't you pull in front of me, Mr. Cow Hauler. Can't take that through the drive-thru. Though I've seen it done. You would be surprised at the things that people pull through the drive-thru of Tim Hortons. It's kind of funny. Like, you're not supposed to pull trailers through here, people. Yet people come through here with their cattle trailers, with their utility trailers, with their big buses and handy vans. I've seen all kinds of stuff. And then it gets all plugged up, right? Because then they realize halfway through that they can't make it. And then everybody's got to back up and let this big guy out of there. And then they don't know how to back the thing up, right? Because, you know, you just need a regular license to drive those things. You don't have to be trained at all. So you got these drivers in there that don't know how to back up. And now you're stuck in the Timmy's drive-thru and you got a lot of angry people. We all just want our Timmy's and you plugged it up. I always laugh when that happens. I just usually go inside. But it would really suck to be stuck behind someone like that. It's kind of funny, actually. Canadians, for the most part, we don't like waiting. Like, North American culture, right? We like things now, now, now. Fast, fast, fast. Faster the better. But we'll wait half an hour in line at Timmy's without saying a word. There's a smart car behind me. I'm trying not to laugh. I would actually like to have one. But it's like a go-kart. Like, imagine hitting a truck head-on in a smart car. Like, say you're a good driver. You had the right amount of rest. You are safe to operate your vehicle. What if they aren't prepared to drive? What if they're not safe to drive? What if they're drunk and they swerve into your lane and take you out? Then it doesn't matter how safe you are. You're still in a smart car. You lose. That's all there is to it. You lose. What did I eat this morning? I feel like I'm having a bit of an allergic reaction right here. Oh, it's my turn. It's my turn. You ready? Could I get a large coffee, 2 milk, and a shot of espresso in it, please? That's it. Super duper. Don't forget the super duper. Now we gotta wait in line here. Cause you know the people in front of me ordered Thanksgiving dinner at Tim Hortons. It's not even Thanksgiving. One thing that I don't understand.
Roll my windows up so they don't know I'm talking about them.
One thing I don't understand. If you go through the drive-thru at Tim Hortons, why do you order, like, dinner for your entire extended family? You're holding up the line, buddy.
How do I get out of here now? Huh? I got my Timmy's.
Oh, and a green light. It's a sign. We should go to Walmart. Excuse me, I'd like to go to Walmart, please. Excuse me? I know you're looking at me. You got a camera pointed right at me on top of that light. I'm here.
Oh, there we go. It's really bright outside. My eyes are sensitive this morning. What's going on?
Weird. Should have brought my shades. All right, there's Walmart. Da-da-da-da. This is the new Walmart. Steinbeck just recently got a Walmart in like the last year or two. Because we're special. We get a Walmart. And instead of having a McDonald's in Walmart, they have a Tim Hortons. I've mentioned that before. This is a stop sign, right?
Yes, we should stop.
Stop sign.
Stop it. Stop sign. Trucker Jack. Stop sign.
I'm in my personal vehicle, but the law is the law. Look at this guy. Look at this guy parks his big rig right here. Right in the front. Guess he doesn't want to walk. Really? You're taking up four spots. Usually I park in the back of the lot, but I don't know, it's Steinbeck, who cares? Whatever. Look at all these Walmart shoppers. These are my people. Oh dear, there's a kerfluffle here in the Walmart parking lot. No, don't take my parking spot. Don't do it. 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 You're doing it. Take my parking spot. That's mine. Actually, you know what? There's another one right here. Hey, hey, right by the carts. Oh, am I going to hit them? Nope. Oh, no. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, yeah, I got this. Oh, yeah. Look a boss. I usually don't like parking beside these cart thingies because people just throw their carts at it thinking that they'll just magically, you know, fall into place, and then they end up hitting the cars around there, and I don't like that. But there we go. Alright. Let's go inside. You guys didn't think I was going to leave you in the car, did you? See what I mean? You go to Walmart, you end up getting a broom. And Lay's, these are so terrible because they make my mouth feel raw. But I just have to have them. They're so good. I don't know what else I need. But I'm sure I'll find about 100 things that I think I need. I got some stuff to hang on my walls at home. And a couple movies. And those hooks.
What?
I know, coming to Walmart's dangerous. Now I'm in the man section. Sorry, I'm in the truck section. Could be a woman section too, I'm not saying that. Could be a woman section. I'm looking for more manly things to hang on my wall, like, you know, pictures of trucks or deer or moose or I don't know, something. I don't know if Walmart has anything like that. I'll just keep sniffing around.
That's what happens. You go to Walmart and money just woo flies away. Just flies away. Bye bye, money. Thank you, Walmart, for all your goodness. Even though it costs money when I'm not making money. Oh well, some things you just gotta get, right? And anyway, so we're gonna head back home now, hang up those pictures that I bought. I sort of want to make. What I'm trying to do by spending this money on these wall thingers, I want my house to feel more homey. I want to make it mine. I want to make it my home, right? And so I bought a couple of things. I'll be buying more things as things go along, just to hang on the walls. I got a lot of walls to fill up now. And I don't know where to find, you know, like, I don't know what else to call it, manly pictures. You know, like pictures of motorbikes and trucks and cars and... Yeah, that kind of stuff. I'm trying to think right now. Where would I find that? Canadian Tire, maybe?
Oh, well. I spent enough for one day. I'm going to go home and get some work done there. I almost bought a stepladder here, actually. I should have. But I'm going to look for a better deal in the States. I need to be able to get on my roof, right? Instead of using my truck to get up. But anyways, we're going to go back home now. So, well, it happened to me again. Minding my own business. Listening to the radio. And Alan Jackson goes and tells you, take a back road home. Okay, Alan, whatever you say. So, we're taking a back road home. This is my area here. One second. I have the right way, but people don't always listen to that. All right, there we go. Another section. Now we're gonna take gravel all the way home. So I can show you a little bit of the backcountry here. This is what I mean. When I talk country, gravel. Gravel roads, you got paved roads, sorry. That's not the biggest level of country you can get. Then again, these roads are very common in my area. This is almost all the roads are gravel if you think about it. Just the main roads are paved. So anyways, let's speed this up. You'll be able to enjoy some fall colors here as we go into the bush. Here you go. Back road, Manitoba.
Found out like one of my best friends growing up, or in my teen years anyways, lives like 5 minutes from me. Apparently he's been watching my videos and he's from the area, so he figured out where I lived. And so after work today he went, made a pass by my house, and then came past and saw me outside, slams on the brakes, reverses, screams into the driveway, Josh, how's it going? Oh man, it was Ginter. So Ginter, so I went and actually looked at the house where he's living at, just a little further back into the bush here. He's like a couple gravel roads over, and he's got a nice big house that he's living in there. His cousin, I think, is it his cousin? Yeah, his cousin built it, and it's like a two-story massive brand new house. It's just beautiful. Maybe one day I'll be able to take the vlog camera there and show you guys. But yeah, it's good to know that I've got like a really good friend of mine who I haven't seen in like 3 years. We were trying to figure out when the last time we hung out was. We couldn't remember. It's been like over 2 years, probably almost 3 years. So now we're like almost neighbors. So that's awesome. These are the things that I bought in the Walmart today. I can show you these tomorrow too though, once they're hanging up. Hey guys, there's the train again. Ginter actually lives like right beside the train tracks. He says you get used to it though, and I do get used to it too. I don't really hear it, except for when I'm vlogging. Because then I always want to run out there with my camera and vlog the train passing, right? I don't know why I have an obsession with trains. Anyways, guys, so a couple more home time vlogs coming up yet. If you don't like the home time vlogs, I apologize. Nothing else I can do about them right now because my truck's in the shop. You can skip over them, and I will make sure to title my first vlog back on the highway something like Back to Trucking or Let's Get Trucking or something like that. You know, I'll make it pretty obvious in the title that we're back on the road. So if you guys don't like these home time vlogs, you can just wait for that one to be released. Other than that, there's still going to be a vlog released every day, 4 a.m. Central Time. I'll see you tomorrow. Same time, same place.